I've made a palm rejection option for OneNote, or actually anything. So you can see my palm, when it hits it, it turns white. And then I can use the stylus without issues or worry. My handwriting's atrocious here, but you can get the idea. In order to do this, here's the fast way. Open up Tablet Pro Studio and scroll down to palm rejection and double click. This will open up this mode right here. This is the float mode, and this will block your palm. To move it, just put your finger here on the black sections and you can move it underneath your hand. Okay, now the rest of this video is going to be talking about how to adjust and modify and change this. So it's not too difficult, and I'll go through all the settings. So stay tuned and watch the whole thing. It's not too long and you'll like what you learn. It's useful for a lot of different things. This is kind of a teaser video about palm rejection. We're working on a solution here with Tablet Pro Studio, and I want to show you what that is so you can start using it right now while we're developing this. I just recently got a Asus ROG Flow Z13, and the palm rejection is a big issue inside of OneNote. There's a lot of issues where if I'm trying to use the action pen, not the action pen, the text pen. So let's say I tap right here to put the cursor, then I start writing and I want to keep going. What happens is it will eventually drop down to my palm. Okay, basically when I'm putting my hand down, it's usually the palm that hits first. It's not the stylus first. I don't go beep, boop. Like it's a weird action. So then I start writing and it's going under my palm, and that's obviously not the goal. So this here is the assist pad, and this is great for using the trackpad here, but you can also use the float mode to do the same thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to use the float mode. That's this bigger one, and you can change the size of these. I'll show you how to do that. And what we're going to do is we're going to turn this thing into a zone that blocks our palm. This is actually works very well. Okay, so let's go ahead and open up the Studio app. So you can single click on the icon here, and let's close the float mode. Okay, so I've added palm rejection here. This file, I can show you the settings for it. All I've done is partial title to match. I've added palm rejection. We'll have this in future builds. If you're watching this video right in the beginning, you may have to do a step or two extra. Okay, so we have our palm rejection one here, preset keywords, don't want to switch to this preset. And what we're going to do is we're going to just copy this mode. So let's say we're going to use the assist pad. So we're going to do copy. We've copied the assist pad from palm rejection. Now we're going to paste it onto OneNote. So we selected OneNote. Let's go ahead and open it up so we can see it. And then we're going to use the paste icon right down here under the word artist pad medium. And now because we did the assist pad, it's not going to paste onto artist pad medium, it's going to paste on the assist pad. So now when we press this, you can see we've got our palm rejection. So now I can place my palm directly on top, and you'll see that it lights up when the palm rejection is being activated. So now when we go over here, we can use this and start writing comfortably. And not worry about it transferring to underneath the palm. Okay, so now to move this, you can put the pen tip on these black sections. If you touch here in the middle, you'll see that it's just activating. These allow you to move it. If you want to make it larger, we're gonna go up here to the top left corner to our gear icon, open the mini editor, legacy editor in the bottom right corner, actually go up one to layout and choose layout of assist pad. Right here, we're going to choose size, and we can increase the size of the assist pad right here. Let's say we want to make this width of 1,000. Back up. Oop, that's the wrong one. That's height of 1,000. Keep this at 700. There we go. That's pretty fancy. All right, so I like this. This is actually a really good size for me. I can move this around, make sure that it drags over the top of my taskbar so I'm not accidentally hitting those things there. Okay, you guys, so that's the majority of it. Let's go back into the artist pad. Now, if you don't want to use an assist pad, you want to use the float mode and use the radial menu. You can use the radial menu either way. Then you would change touch mode type to float. So we would go back here to palm rejection. We would choose copy mode. Float, notice float is selected here. Copy type of pro touch mode, copy, and then we would paste it back over here on OneNote. We'd paste it onto float mode right here, like that. All right, guys, that's all you have to do. The button itself, so you have an idea of what's actually being done here. So a little bit more detail. Palm rejection edit, legacy editor. Here, this is just a blank button. Okay, and then if we go to assist pad, actually both of these in the corners, there's a move grip on both sides. I have this as 80, 20, 10, and 0 there. Okay, you can find this file is already in the online presets. If you want to download it right now, just go to settings. And online presets right here, you can go there and download that. If you don't want to make your own, it's pretty easy. Just drop it over into your presets folder, open assigned presets folder, and just put it in here. All right, you guys, if you have questions about this palm rejection solution, please put it in the comments section, and I will happily answer those. Join us in our Discord channel, where we have a lot of conversation about how to use Tablet Pro Studio, how we use Tablet Pro Studio to make desktop applications a lot more easy to use with touch, the pen, standing, without a keyboard, without a desk, in basically any situation that you want to be productive. All right, until next time, stay creative and have a wonderful day.